Imagine being asked to run millions of concurrent tasks inside your Java application, each on its own thread. I can imagine your first thought would be, it's not possible. But in Java 21 and above, not only it's possible, it's exactly how you should be doing it. For many years, we have been told threads are expensive, blocking is bad, and reactive programming is the only way forward. But virtual threads came to change all that. So what are virtual threads? They are threads, but also ultra-lightweight. Unlike the traditional threads, they are managed by JVM instead of operating system, which means they are no longer limited by the number of CPU cores we have in our system. Also, you can create hundreds, even millions of them, without paying that traditional high memory cost. Each virtual thread uses just a few kilobytes of stack memory. They can be paused and resumed instantly, and the JVM efficiently mapped to a very small pool of real threads behind the scenes. So the bottom line is, writing a blocking code is not blocking anymore. Let's put this into code. Assume we are building a dashboard which needs to fetch the user profile and the purchases from two remote slow APIs. Let's start with the reactive way using Project Reactor. It's concise, but it has its own DSL. We had to change the getUser and getPurchases to return a non-blocking response. Notice the use of mono.zip to combine async calls and the chaining of the operations. It works and it scales, but it's not straightforward Java code. Now, here's the same logic using virtual threads, a bit longer, but pure Java, easy to debug and maintain. If you are used to work with executor service, this code should feel familiar. You submit tasks, get futures, wait for results, and shut down the executor. The only change is that the executor is creating virtual threads instead of traditional threads. But if we want a more concise, cleaner approach that also benefits from the latest Java concurrency patterns, we can use structured concurrency. This code runs two blocking calls concurrently on virtual threads within a single scope. The structured concurrency scope ensures that both tasks complete or cancel all of them if one fails. It automatically handles waiting, error propagation, and cleaning up, making concurrent programming simpler, safer, and easier to reason about. So, when you should reach for virtual threads? Virtual threads excel when your code is performing blocking input-output operations, such as JDBC calls, API requests, or file system reads. Also, if you care about readability or just want to ship features faster instead of wrestling with the complex reactive stack. And the best part is, you can start using the new virtual threads only where it makes sense. For the quick reality check, concurrency bugs still a thing, and CPU-bound tasks, you can still melt your machine if you go wild. You should also be aware some tools haven't fully adapted yet, and some profilers don't recognize virtual threads properly. And the most important one, virtual threads would not fix a bad architecture. Spaghetti code is still spaghetti, just faster. If you are using Netty, building streaming APIs, or dealing with thousands of concurrent calls, and need a real back pressure, Reactive still has the edge. But for the most of us, virtual threads can cover all our use cases, but with less cognitive overhead. So, the answer is no. Virtual threads didn't kill reactive programming. It killed the idea that we should go reactive in order to scale. And for the most of us, that's a big win. So, if you're already using virtual threads, drop your experience in the comments. And if you want to stick with reactive, I would love to hear why.